I would now like to tell you something about large telescopes of the present time. We have seen right at the beginning of this talk that though Galileo used a small telescope at the time that he was making observations, it was the largest telescope in the world being used for that purpose. So the word large is rather relative here. So if you come to the Arecibo Grijalva telescope, will be very impressed by its overall size and the size of the telescope dome and the observatory. But a 2-meter telescope is now not really considered to be at the forefront of astronomical research, even though it appears to be very large. When I was in school, I read that the largest telescope in the world at that time was the Palomar 5-meter telescope, which is a very famous telescope. And I'm sure many people have heard about it even now. It is in active use, but it is not the largest telescope in the world at the present time. It was believed then that it would not be possible to make anything which is bigger than the Palomar telescope. The simple reason for that was the mirror which is required for such a large telescope has got to be made very massive and very thick, because one needs the mirror to be very rigid. As you point the telescope at an object, the orientation of the mirror related to the ground changes, and therefore there are different stresses on it due to gravity. And these tend to distort the mirror to very small amounts. But because the wavelength of light is so small, even the small distortions can produce large distortions in the images. To avoid this, the bigger the mirror gets, the more massive it would have to be made. And in fact, it would then become so large and so heavy that it would tend to break under its own weight. So therefore, it was believed that a mirror larger than 5 meters was not possible on Earth, and that astronomers would have to wait, for example, to go to the moon to make a bigger telescope. But as in all aspects of life, these matters changed with technology. As new technology became available, it was became possible to structure the mirrors in a different way, and also to use new materials which are very strong and very light. And therefore, it became possible to make larger mirrors. So I show you in the next slide the 4 telescopes which are close to each other. They are located at Cerro Paranal in Chile. Now, these telescopes belong to the European Southern Observatory, which is headquartered in Germany, in Munich. The telescopes are in the south in Chile because that is an extraordinarily good location for getting excellent astronomical imaging and very good atmospheric conditions nearly all through the year. So several countries have come together and set up the European Southern Observatory, which has built and runs these 4 8-meter telescopes. So 8 meters is about the largest size that people have used, reached in a single mirror. Now, in the next image, I show you a picture of the 8-meter mirror where it was being made. It is not as mounted as the telescope. It's rather difficult to photograph a mirror as large as this. Simply one can't get good angles, and it's very, one really needs to see these telescopes to see how to feel how large the mirrors are. So the biggest telescope now, of course, the reflecting telescopes, are the 2 Keck telescopes and the SALT telescope, which is not yet in full operation, but which may go in operation in October this year. So the Keck telescopes, which have been operating for many years now, they use a new technology which is known as the segmented mirror technology. So these mirrors have a diameter of 10 meters, but it is not a monolithic mirror like the mirror of the very large telescope which I just showed you. Now here is a picture of the mirror, and you will see first of all that rather than being circular, it appears to have a different regular and geometric shape. There is a small red object at the center of the mirror, And if you look at it carefully, you would find that it is actually a human being just stretching its arms, which tells you how large the overall mirror is. The new technology employed here, the segmented mirror, is segmented mirror technology, where you see that there is a large number of smaller mirrors, which are about a meter in diameter, which are stuck together to produce an overall shape. So you see that there are 36 hexagonal segments here, and then if you look at the diameter end to end, that measures about 10 meters. The point in having segmented mirrors like this is that it is much easier to make a large number of small segments than one large monolithic mirror. Then, because if you made a very large mirror, and if there was a distortion or a crack or some other damage to it at any one point, then the whole mirror would become useless. But in this new technology, if one of the mirrors were damaged, then one could just remove it and replace it with another mirror. What you have to understand now is that these mirrors are arranged in such a manner that they achieve a near perfect paraboloidal shape. So, so now, how does one do that? That's because each of these segments can actually be pushed using an active element. So there are, it's a computer control device, and then there's a constant testing for the shape of the surface as the telescope tracks the star, and any corrections which are required to maintain the overall alignment of the shape of the mirror are constantly made. Now, there's another very important correction which can also be made, not in the primary mirror, but in one of the 6-inch deformable mirror. Here, the point is that because of the distortions in the atmosphere, there is a constant twinkling of the stars that you observe with the naked eye. And so the twinkling of the stars results in an extension of their images from a point source into a spread out source when you're in a recording device like a CCD. So a star which should appear as a point now appears like a circle with a radius of about 1 arcsecond. Now this spreading is because of the turbulence in the atmosphere. And what adaptive optics tries to do is to compensate for the distortion in the shape of the in the point spread function of the star by distorting a secondary mirror in such a way that the original shape of the star is nearly restored. I shall show you an image of this in a moment, but before that, I have here a very beautiful picture of another large telescope, which is known as the Southern African Large Telescope, which has a physical diameter of about 11 meters, but its effective diameter is only as much as the keck.